Namaste, and welcome to our continuing series, the Savitri series. Today, part 10, from the mother. It was about the word, the primal sound. Sri Aurobindo speaks of it in Savitri, the essence of the word, and how it will express itself, how it will bring in the possibility of a supramental expression that will take the place of languages. I began by speaking to him about the different languages, their limitations and possibilities, and I warned him against the defamations imposed on languages with the idea of making them a more flexible means of expressing something else. I told him how completely ridiculous it all was, and that it didn't correspond at all to the truth. Then, little by little, I began ascending to the origin. So, yesterday again, I had the same experience, a whole world of knowledge, of consciousness, and of certainty, precluding the least possibility of contradiction, discussion, or opposition. The possibility does not exist. It doesn't exist. And the mind was absolutely silent and immobile, listening with obvious pleasure, because these things had never before come into my consciousness. I had never been concerned with them in that way. It was completely new, not new in principle, but completely new in action. The experiences are multiplying. A sound that can bring in the supramental force? Yes. While speaking, you see, I went back to the origin of sound. Sri Aurobindo describes it very clearly in Savitri. The origin of sound, the moment when what we call the word becomes a sound. So I had a kind of perception of the essential sound before it becomes a material sound. And I said, when this essential sound becomes a material sound, it will give birth to the new expression which will express the supramental world. I had the experience itself at that moment. It came directly. I spoke in English, and Sri Aurobindo was concretely, almost palpably present. Now it has gone away. 6 June 1961. You know, Savitri is an exact description, not literature, not poetry, although the form is very poetical. An exact description, step by step, paragraph by paragraph, page by page. As I read, I relived it all. Besides, many of my own experiences that I recounted to Sri Aurobindo seem to have been incorporated into Savitri. He has included many of them. This explained to me why, suddenly as I read it, I lived the experience, line by line, page by page. The realism of it is astounding. 7 July 1961. Disciple, I'm rereading Savitri. Mother, lucky man. I would love to read it again. And the more you read, the more marvelous it becomes. 15 July, 1961. In the final analysis, everything obviously depends upon the Supreme's will. Because if one looks deeply enough into the question, even physical laws and resistances are nothing for him. But this kind of direct intervention takes place only at the extreme limit. If his will is to be expressed in opposition, as it were, to the whole set of laws governing the manifestation, well, that only comes at the very last second. Sri Aurobindo has expressed this so well in Savitri, so well. At least three times in the book, he has expressed this will that abolishes all established laws, all of them, and all the consequences of these laws. The whole formidable colossus of the manifestation, so that in the face of it all, that can express itself. And this takes place at the very last second, so to speak, at the extreme limit of possibility. Namaste.